Hi students, welcome to my YouTube channel. Today I am going to teach you reported speech. So what is reported speech and what we are going to learn in this video? So in this video we are going to learn direct speech and indirect speech. So how we can change from direct to indirect speech and some important rules while we are changing from direct speech to indirect speech, what rules we have to follow. So these are the things I am going to explain in this video. This is only part one video. I do some other videos, part two and part three. So since it is a use subject, okay, let's start our set class. So first of all you must know what is direct speech. So direct speech means there is a kind of speech which is reported by some other person exactly in the words spoken by the speaker. So here in the direct speech we can see exact words that was spoken by the speaker, we can see in the direct speech, especially under the quotation part we can understand the exact, we can know the exact words spoken by the speaker, we can see. So this is direct speech. In the indirect speech is a speech which is reported by some other person. So indirect speech is also speech, but it is how it is translating the speaker's words in other way. So that is in the indirect speech. Okay, so the next one is what we see in the direct speech, especially some technical words we must know. So here look at this. Ravi told Vamsi that she was an MP. Okay, so here we see three parts. So in the first part, Ravi told Vamsi. This is actually, the sentence is in indirect speech. So in the indirect speech, what we know. So this is the Ravi told Vamsi. So who told to whom? Who spoke to whom? We know. So here Ravi speaks to Vamsi. So he is the speaker and Vamsi is the listener. So Ravi speaks to Vamsi. So Ravi is the speaker and Vamsi is the listener of this dialogue. So these things tell and explain by the reporting verb. So this part we call reporting verb. The reporting verb, what we know? We know who is the speaker, who is the listener. Who is the speaker and who is the listener? Who is the object? In other words, we know. So these dialogues, who spoke to whom, we know in the reporting verb. So look at this, that is the connective part. So this is the, it may change from the model to model. So in this model we have this connective word conjunction, that is in some other model, if or whether, according to that model it may change, but this part is conjunction part. And the other part is, this is the reporting speech part. This is what we call it, reporting speech. Reporting speech means the words which are spoken by the speaker are translated into other words. That is in the reporting speech we can see. So it's very important. Reporting verb tells who is the speaker, who is the listener. Okay, and the reporting speech is the translation of the speaker's words. Okay, let's go for the model. Okay, come to this model, model number one. Okay, this is model number one. Okay, model number one, model number two, this is only for our understanding, not for depending, maybe it change according to the teacher's prior case. So model number one, here he says to Sita, I am unwell. So this is direct speech. How you know, sir? This is in the quotation part. Quotation part means exact words of the speaker. So as I said in my previous slide, this is the reporting verb. This is the reporting verb and reporting speech. Reporting verb tells you who is the speaker, who is the listener of this dialogue. He says to Sita. So he is the listener. Listener of this dialogue. So exact words of the speaker. Understand? So he spoke these words, exact I am unwell. That is the direct words that are rolled out from the speaker. So speaker and listener, this is reporting verb and the words reporting speech. So in this is a statement, assertive sentence. How we change? I tell you very carefully, you listen. He, you know, boys, whenever the reporting verb in we see say to, you know, whenever you see says or say to, you have to write tell. Understand? Say, no change. Okay, exactly you can write says. But whenever you see says in the direct speech, says to, you write tells in the indirect speech, say to, tell in the indirect speech. But say come, you take again say, says come, you take again says. Here I see I have reporting verb is says to. This is very, very important. According to this, we have to change the tense. So says to. So says to comes, you write what? Tells. He tells Sita. You know, ask me, sir, here says to is there. Why you write tells? Yeah. Says to come, you write tells. Say to come, you write tell. Says only come, you write again says. Okay, only says to or say to, you write tells and tell in indirect speech. So since it is a statement model, is an assertive model, you write that. This is the connective word, conjunction. In this model, the conjunction is that. Now, remove comma and quotation and go for the next. So the first one is here I. So another interesting concept. So whenever in the quotation part, if you see first person means I or we. So change the pronoun according to the speaker. If you see the second person, you change according to the listener. If you see third person, that means he, she, it, or they. You know, no change. You understand? If you see the first person, where? Here. In the quotation part, you see first person, that means I or we, change according to the speaker. Who is the speaker here? He is the speaker. So in this sentence. Okay, here Ravi may be with you. Ravi is there. Krishna is there. So he is the speaker. So if you see here you, that means second person, change according to the listener. Who is the listener here? Sita. So take the Sita's pronoun. For example, here you see he, she, it, or they. no change, write as it is here. Understand? So in this example, I see first person I. I look at this I. So I have to change according to the speaker. Who is the speaker here? Speaker is he. So I have to, already he is a pronoun, so that I take pronoun he. For example, in place of he, Ravi is there. So I is the first person. First person change according to the speaker. Speaker is here, Ravi, for example. So Ravi, don't write Ravi again. So the, what is the pronoun of Ravi? He. Understand? Like that. So you write, take he. So what is the next one? Am. Am means tense related. Okay. So the next question come. Okay. Persons we change already. Already I mentioned clearly in the here in this table. Now go for the tense. Here the tense is in the simple present tense. So before going to attempt this part, you please go back and check reported verb. So here what that word? Here say or says, tell or tells, which means or will say or shall say. So if we, here you see simple present tense or future tense in the reported verb, no change here in the tense. No change. It is in the simple present tense. Indirect speech also is in simple present tense. It is in the past tense. Simple indirect speech also in the past tense. No need to change the tense when the reported verb is in simple present tense or in future tense, which means say or says, says to, tells or will say, like. If any of the words are in reported verb, no need to change the tense. So obviously here we need not to change any tense. So tense change doesn't mean write exact word, which means you may think, sir, shall we write am here? No. What I said here, no change in the tense. No change in the tense. That means here he accept is. Since am is a present tense be form, so what is the present tense be form which is agreement with the subject he? That is. He is. He is unwell. Full stop. So no need to write quotations again. Understand? He tells Sita that he is unwell. That is your final answer in indirect speech. I tell you again. So students, don't get confused. All the things we can see in the very first model. That's why we confuse a bit. So be patient and you again go back and check the changes in the same model one. Okay, I tell you one more time. He says to Sita, I am unwell. Okay, so reporting verb, he says to Sita, reported speech, I am unwell. Okay, so let's start. He, so whenever you see says to means you write tells in indirect speech. Say, for example, say is there, you write say only. Whenever you see says to, then you change that word into tells. Again, Sita. Since this is a statement model, this is an assertive sentence, so you write that as the connective word. So that in the model one, you write the connective word that. So here you write that. And what is the next one? Person. Here is the I am unwell. First word is I. I is means which person? We know I, we, first person. First person always change according to the speaker. Second person, for example, here, that is you, change according to listener. For example, in place, third person is there, he, she, it, they, that is a third person, no change. And another interesting concept, students, these changes not for model one, for all models, not for the model one. Okay, if you learn here, this is no need to learn again and again in the other models. So in the next model 2, model 3, interrogative model or imperative sentences, in all models, you can use this rule. Okay, so I is here. I is the first person. In this example, I change according to the speaker. Speaker is he. I write he. Is it okay? So the next one. Go for the next. Am. Am is in the present tense. So before change the tense, you please go and check the reported verb is in which tense. Here in the reported verb is in present tense. Present tense means says to. Say. For example, future tense will say, shall say. So if it is simple present tense or simple future tense, no need to change the tense. No need to change the tense. So here am. So why I take is here? So what I said, no change in the tense. That doesn't mean you write exact word again here. So I accept am in the present tense, but his subject is here, he. So it take is. Is am or present tense be forms. He is. So write unwell. Is it okay? So this is indirect speech. Don't write quotations again and just put full stop. All indirect speech are statements. No need to write question marks, exclamation marks. Just put full stop at the end of the sentence. That is indirect speech. Let's go for one more example. One more example. Ravi says to Rani, she is an intelligent girl. Okay, let's start how we change. So this is the reporting verb, and this is the quotation part, exact words. This is the reported speech. How we change Ravi? Ravi, right? Ravi. So I, as I said, says to come, you write tells. Ravi tells Rani. So remove commas and quotations. You, what is the connective word in this model? That is that. Ravi tells Rani that. And the next one is, here the subject pronoun is she. She is which person? She is the third person. She is the third person. According to the third person, what I said, if it is the first person, change according to the speaker. Second person, change according to the listener. If it is the third person, since she is the third person, no change. So write she again. She. And next one is verb change. Is. Is means what? Okay. Present tense. Whether we change present tense or not, depend on what? Depend on the reporting verb. The reporting verb is in simple present tense or simple future tense. No need to change the tense here. So we still are in simple present tense. She take what? Is. Okay, no problem. She is an intelligent girl, and put full stop. This is the first model. I understand. I think you understand this. Go for the model number two. This is very, very important. Model number two. Ram said to Rani, I am unwell. Okay, this is the model. So take as in the previous model, Ram said to Rani, reporting verb and reporting speech. So we change, let's start Ram. Okay, not like in the previous model, here says or tells, say. It is said, said. That means past tense. You see reported verb is in past tense. For example, look at here, direct speech, indirect speech. How these words change? Look at this. If you see said, you write said in the indirect speech. If you see said to in the direct speech, you write told in. You understand? Said as it is. Said to changes into told. Okay. So this said to changes into told. Next one, Rani. Rani. Remove quotation. Remove comma and quotations. So what is here? I means which person? First person. I means first person. So already I told you here, this is applied for all models. All models. So I means speaker. Okay. So I means according to the speaker, we have to change. Who is the speaker here? Ram is the speaker. What is the pronoun of the speaker? Ram. So Ram is a masculine gender. So we use Ram pronoun is he. Okay. Next one. Am. So if this tense is depend on reporting verb. In the previous model, we didn't change any tense. As it is, we write. But here you know said to is the past tense. Said it is in the past tense. So we have to change the table. It's very, very important. changing the table. So if it is the reported verb is in, if reported verb in past tense. So how you know such past tense? Said to is the past tense. Said is the past tense. So we some changes occur from direct to indirect speech, especially in the tenses. So if you know tenses well, not at all the problem. In case not, you please follow this technique. If in case is, am, are, for example, you see in the direct speech, so you change according was and were. So use any of the helping verb is, am, are, you see in the direct speech, you change into was and were. For example, you see have and has. In direct speech, you change into had. For example, you see V1, you change according to V2. For example, you see V2, you have to write the indirect speech had plus V3. Okay, so can, will, shall, may, okay, must. You see, you change them. Can changes into could, will changes into would, shall should changes into should, may might, and might comes must comes have to. So okay, later I explain all these things when the examples come. So this is the easy one. If you don't know much knowledge about tenses, you can follow like this. Is, whenever you see is, am, or in direct speech, you can write was, were in indirect speech. Have, has, you see, you write had. If you see it is in the V1, that is simple plain tense, he writes V2. If it is a V2 in the direct speech, you write had plus V3 in the indirect speech. Can, could, will, would, shall, should, may, might, and must have to. So these are the observations, these are the changes we can have from direct to indirect speech. So in this example, am is here. So but the reported verb is in the past tense. Whenever the reported verb is in the past tense, these changes occur. So look at here, am is there. So am is in this box, is, am, or. So I change accordingly was and were. So you know was for singular, were for plural. He is the singular, I have to write he was unwell. That is the answer. You understand? For example, another example, Gopi said they ate all mangoes. So Vahui write this Gopi. Now here said to turns into told, but here is only said. So simply write said. So what is the connective word in this model? That. So the next one is they. They means what? Third person. Third person change or not? No change. If it is a first person, speaker. Second person, listener. Third person, no change. So you write as it is they. Now come to the verb. So before going to this, you please check here. This the reported verb is in past tense. So whenever it is in the past tense, these changes follow. So 8 is the V2. 8 is the V2. So V2 takes what? Had plus V3. They had E10. V3 form is E10. All mangoes. This is the model number 2. Okay. So in my next video, I continue this model. Okay.